Eduardo Pérez Guzmán has already cleared many of Germany's bureaucratic hurdles. He now has a work permit and a job for a car manufacturer.
I work in control engineering. What I actually do is to simulate physical models and how these models can be controlled or regulated.
The 33-year-old Mexican has lived in Aachen for 2 years now. He has an engineering diploma from Mexico and another degree in Germany. He found his dream job with the Ferchau company. But first, he needed a work permit.
Ferchau asked for a 3-year permit. But the foreigner's registration office said that was too long. They only gave me a permit for 2 years, so I've already had to apply this year for an extension.
Guzman's boss at Ferchau says that's unnecessary red tape. His company has more than 100 unfilled positions. But hiring foreign applicants can be a slow and difficult process. Some employers would prefer the old green card system to the current laws.
The advantage of the green card was you could launch your project immediately. You could hire staff, and all the administration and registrations could be carried out afterward or in parallel. Today we have to complete all the bureaucracy first and have a permit before you can even begin working.
The German economy has rebounded surprisingly well from the 2009 economic crisis. And so the demand for well-trained personnel is growing. But as Germany's population declines, the number of students is also declining, especially in technical fields. More foreign workers will only solve part of the problem. Politicians are split over what to do. Vice Chancellor Guido Westerwelle says training Germans should take priority over recruiting foreigners.
We have to qualify those we have in Germany, our own young generation, so that they can do the jobs that require skilled employees. Our first task must be to train our own people, and especially our own young generation.
The Association of German Engineers wants a combination of training and foreign recruitment. But at the moment, foreigners have to earn at least 66,000 euros a year to stay in Germany long term. The association says that's asking too much.
We don't believe in creating hurdles. These hurdles were put up because people were afraid companies would pay dumping prices for foreign specialists. That hasn't happened. Skilled employees all over the world know what they're worth, and so we shouldn't introduce these kinds of limits. Such obstacles just aren't necessary.
Das sind hier Hemmnisse, die einfach nicht notwendig sind.
Cem Özdemir, co-leader of the Green Party, is the son of Turkish guest workers. He says foreign specialists should not only find work, but also a home in Germany.
We don't need more guest workers. New immigrants need a roadmap for integration. They need to learn about this society and be able to bring their families here. If I don't feel comfortable, then I can't integrate. The goal must be for foreigners to eventually become Germans.
Ziel muss sein, dass aus Ausländern über kurz oder lang Inländer werden.
Eduardo Pérez Guzmán isn't quite German yet, but he's hoping his next step will be a permanent residence permit.
The labor office says you can stay another year with no problems. And after that, I can apply for a permanent residence permit. So that's a whole additional process. I have to consider when to begin and what I need for a permanent residence permit.
But if more obstacles are placed in his way, Eduardo Pérez Guzmán just might change his mind. With his education and training, good jobs are beckoning all over the world.